Hey, what's going on, you guys? It's your girl Shantaesays. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, make sure you guys go ahead and hit that subscribe button. So I want to talk about something very important, very common that a lot of you men are going through, and maybe a lot of you women are currently doing that you need to stop. And that's co-parenting with bitter moms and talking about the disconnection between the siblings because of the bitter mama. Guys, just like I have, we've seen the crazy baby mama in the grocery store arguing. We've driven past baby mamas throwing clothes out the window. We've seen women slashing tires. We've even seen them disrespecting the current spouse or the new baby mama, you know, by creating fake profile pages to be nosy or just to see what's going on. Like, it's so many crazy things. And a lot of times it's, you know, a symptom of just being hurt. You know what I mean? Being hurt, being mad. And so you take it out on the person who did it, but you're not just hurting that person. Like, you're hurting the kids in that relationship as well. And you're also hurting the spouse or the new baby mama who probably did nothing to you. Like, sadly, a lot of women's excuse is, oh, he made me that way. He created me to be crazy. But at what point do you start taking responsibility for your own actions? Like, at the end of the day, we're all adults. So, you know, we all get hurt. We've all had a broken heart. Like, I'm sorry that you went through that. But at some point, you got to get over it. You know what I mean? You got to be more mature and say, you know what? It is what it is. We have a child together. We have to learn how to get along. And if the new person in his life is going to be around your kids, you need to be talking to that person too, because you need to get to know the person that's going to be around your kids. And then two, on top of that, if that other person has kids by the same guy, so now we have, you know, more than one woman with kids by the same person, you need to do everything in your power to make sure that those kids have some type of relationship. It doesn't just happen on Maury. It doesn't just happen in movies where we see, you know, these couples that get together and then later find out that they're siblings. I blame the parents. Point blank, period. We have to get to a point where our children know they're siblings. There should be no reason why they hook up with somebody who is their sibling simply because the parents were you know, neglecting to make sure that the kids had some type of relationship. Now, for this, I can speak on experience, you guys. So, I have three little sisters, I have an older brother, and then I have another brother and another sister who my dad doesn't claim. Now, mind you, on my mama's side, it's just me, my older sister, and a little sister who was adopted. So, my dad has all of these kids, right? So, growing up, I didn't really have a tight relationship with these kids because we were all kind of spread out. I was in Topeka, my brother and sister was in Kansas City, and then my other three little sisters ended up moving to Portland, Oregon. But I say this to say this. Over the years, even though my dad didn't do his job to make sure we had a connection, I felt like it was my job to kind of be that glue to kind of pull us together. Because sadly, even at this point, my little sisters are around probably 16 or 17 at this moment, and they have never met our older brother. So hypothetically speaking, let's say they got older and ran into him in a whole nother state and didn't know who this guy was. Luckily, they've seen pictures. But, you know, maybe they had never seen who this guy was and didn't commit incest. Like, that is crazy. And who do you put the blame on? You can't blame those two. They didn't even know about each other. And they had never met. You know what I mean? So I definitely believe that it's a parent's job to make sure that those kids have some type of connection. Now, women, you know, men, they think different than women. You know, sometimes men feel like, you know, let me keep them separate because I don't want any drama. That's not the solution. The solution is, how do I mix my family? I have a mixed family. I have kids over here and kids over here. How do I make sure that there is a connection? How do I make sure that both of my baby mothers get along? Like, that is very important. Keeping them separate for the sake of drama? No, either somebody's being childish or somebody needs to step it up and really just be an adult and say, you know what, I'm letting my old ways go. And then women, you guys seem to think that, oh, I'm just a crazy baby mama and think it's fun. That's nothing cute about being trashy and, you know, negative and spiteful. Like, there's nothing attractive about that. And he no longer looks like the bad baby daddy that you're making him out to be. You're just looking like the crazy baby mama. Like, let's get it together, you guys. Anyways, it's your girl. I don't want to keep this too long. So make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. I'll be back with more. Deuces.